name is Inderbir, mm-hmm. and date of birth is 2nd July 1940.
And what is today's date?
Today is 5th of June.
How old were you in 1984?
About 44.
And what was your occupation at that time?
I was a housewife plus looking after my business.
What was your husband's business?
He is in oil and gas, laying of oil and gas pipelines.
And where were you in June 1984?
I was very much in Calcutta, where we lived at that time.
Mm-hmm. And how and when did you hear about the violence in Harbandar Sahib?
It was, I think, the next day. It came in the papers, newspaper. TV, we didn't have it, basically at that time we didn't have a TV. Mm-hmm. We didn't have a TV at that time. So it was in the newspaper that we read about the violence, and we were a little practically shocked about it. Though the news were not very explicit.
Mm-hmm. And do you remember what you heard or saw on the TV, and what was the news? And
you see, basically it was, I would say, trying to justify the attack on Golden Temple, basically saying we have, government is flushing out the terrorists, and there are people who resisted them, and that's why they had to shoot and they had to attack that place. Mm-hmm. That was basically in the newspaper.
And do you remember anything from previous news or any other reading or?
Yes, it was. You see, for last month or two before that, every second day it would be Bhindranwala is a terrorist, he is harboring terrorists in the Golden Temple, they are collecting arms and ammunition inside the Golden Temple, trying to create a hype about the things. I think they had in mind that they want to attack it, and they built up all that before.
And what was your reaction when you heard the news, and what do you think? What did you think? What did you feel?
So basically, the way they were putting it at that time, that there is a terrorist are there and they are doing this, they are doing that, and they had attacked Golden Temple. Initially, one thought, okay, they had flushed out the terrorists. But as the news came, it was very obvious. It was not an attack on just to flush out the terrorists. It was basically to crush a community. Because if they wanted to take out the terrorists or flush out the terrorists, they could have chosen any day of the year and a time when there are hardly any people inside the Golden Temple. But they chose, I think it was the 5th of June, today exactly the same date. On the 5th of June, it was Guru Arjan Dev Ji's Shahidi Day. On that day, millions and millions of people are there. They come from all over, villages, children, women. And the Golden Temple, there is hardly a place even to walk at that time. Why did they choose that day? Were all these women, children who had come to pay their respects or visit the Golden Temple, were they terrorists? They wanted to shoot. That is why ultimately when it came out to be known that there were hundreds and hundreds of people killed that day, it was not necessary. So that obviously doesn't give justification to the attack. That was our reaction, basically.
And where were you in November 1984?
I was in Calcutta at that time also. That I remember very, very clearly. Because that day I had a few guests, it was 31st of October I think, and I had a few guests, they wanted to go to New Market and do some shopping, and I took them for shopping around 12:30, around that time. And the minute we reached there, we saw the atmosphere, something was uneasy about the place, and my driver immediately told me that we should go back home, because somebody is saying that somebody has shot a camera. So there can be trouble, so we may as well head home. So we immediately turned back and went back to the house. But at that time when we came, we reached home, the TV was announcing and telling with some sick security man, he has killed her. So we were a little worried, because being on a sick community, they can be targeted anytime, anywhere. Because that's one community which can't hide themselves.
Right. see. And did you hear more things on the news which you remember, or some writing, or you know, anything about the riots?
Riots, you see, we saw the riots, most of the things.
Hmm.
Because, in fact, my daughter was in Delhi, and she was on the train at that time. At 4 o'clock in the evening, she boarded a train for Pune. The minute we came to know that, in fact, the minute Indira Gandhi's body was taken out of Ames, the atmosphere in Delhi was very vicious. And they made it a point to broadcast it, show it on the TV again and again to create a hype. And that worried us all, because the children were in the school. Our friends' children, they were in the school. So immediately everybody ran around to pick up the children from the school, bring them back home. And as there were no mobiles at that time easily available, I couldn't get in touch with my daughter even. I'm extremely worried about it, and called Bombay that the minute she reaches there, someone to pick her up. It was quite a panicky affair for everybody.
And did you, any family member, friend, anybody become target to the violence? Do you remember stories from that time which you would like to share?
You sure. You see, in Delhi, my husband's nephew, they lived in Janakpuri, somewhere near Tirthagar, which was, I think, basically the center of all this drama there. And he had a jeep. So they were pointing out and trying to find out where is this Sardar boy whose jeep is this, is what they want to kill. Because it was very, very evident. They were just picking up Sardar with a turban, with a hair, anywhere, everywhere. And in fact, he had to lock the house, and three houses away, their neighbors, they gave him a shelter and told him, you're not getting out of this room. For next 3 days, he was just locked up in that room. He was no longer there, and the house was locked. And they were targeting it. And fortunately, he survived, but he saw quite a few we who didn't. Where they reached before they could save themselves. So it was bad. It was terrible. Very, very bad.
Any other incident that you remember, or any news which struck, which still is in your memory, very fresh, which instigated?
You see, it's not instigation, so I wouldn't say. In fact, where we live in Calcutta, the area is pretty safe. And my sister-in-law, they lived in Bhawanipur, which is, again, more Sardars living there. And she was there with her elder son. Three children were studying somewhere near my house, so I immediately went and picked them up and brought them to my house. But to take them out of their house, there were stones were being thrown at their house. So I just told them that you just stay away, don't open the windows and everything. So at 2 o'clock at night, I took my car with my driver and went, told him, just cover your heads and just come out of your house. So at 2 o'clock I went there at night, brought my mother and son to the car and drove back. Meanwhile, her husband, who was a contractor, he was in Barrackpur doing army work. So when he was coming back, they targeted them both. He was there and his brother was there. They targeted him, and stones were thrown at them, and they were about, you know, they pushed him, and his eye spectacles, they broke. But immediately, fortunately for them, there was an army truck coming from the other side. The minute these people saw the army truck, they ran away. So the army people, they picked them up and brought them to the secure places. So these were what we saw there.
And you were in Calcutta, did you feel any kind of a difference in the attitude of the people, or, you know, a kind of a tension?
Fortunately, in Calcutta, I must give credit to Jyoti Basu, who was the chief minister at that time. He immediately flew back to Calcutta, and it was his orders that nothing is going to happen. And they made sure that with the minimum casualty, everything was controlled. So I feel wherever these things happened, it was happening because the police and the people in government, they were all handling each other. Otherwise, if they wanted to, they can control Calcutta, they can control anywhere. But they control. But after this 84 riots, 6 were targeted every year. They were given a very, very shabby treatment. At the airport, you have to take off your turban, and wherever you go, they will call you names which are not very comfortable to hear. And wherever 2, 3, 4 people are sitting together, they said, you are making a Khalistan here. Things like that. It was very, very uncomfortable for quite a few years. It took about 4 to 5 years for the general public to understand that this is, everybody is not a terrorist walking on the road.
And did you continue to live where you were living after this violence?
Yes. Yes.
And have you spoken to anybody about it, about 1984, after whatever?
Yes, I have spoken to my grandchildren and told them about it, about the history, about the things. Trying not to make any specific comment about the situation, but they should know what happened.
And with friends or with any other family except your grandchildren, have you had any kind of conversations, something you would like to share with us?
I don't think so. I had to do that because we were so far away in Calcutta. But in Delhi or in Chandigarh, where my parents lived at that time, so whenever you go and you come back, this was a common topic. But one thing was very, very clear. Everywhere you go, you sit, it was that Sikh community is not going to leave 84 attack on Darbar Sahib unpunished. Jallianwala was taken revenge after so many years by Bhagat Singh. So the Golden Temple is something, Jallianwala Bagh was just a place. Golden Temple is one place which every Sikh really revers, and attack on that, and in this manner, which was not necessary, was very, the whole community was hurt about it. There's no doubt about it.
And have you had any nightmares, flashbacks, something about, did 84 bring any changes to your outlook, your life, perspectives?
Basically, not to me, not to my family there, but on the whole, everybody started thinking in terms of, even in Calcutta, we never thought we'll come and build a house in Delhi or live here or in Punjab. Then we started thinking that even in India, you have to be somewhere where your community is there. You must have a place to come back to. That insecure feeling started creeping.
But Delhi was affected the most, and then you moved from Calcutta to Delhi, and what were
you
the...
See, whatever still, you have your community here. You have people of your own community here. Tomorrow you want to get together, you have a strength.
And why, in your opinion, all this happened in 1984?
You see, I'm not into politics much. But according to me, they were allowed to happen. If this thing was going on, they could have stopped it long back before it took such a big shape. It could have been done much before. But I think it was the politics. For their personal gains, different parties, different politicians, they played up, and ultimately the game they played became too harsh for them. So it was a politics which allowed all this to happen. It could have been avoided very comfortably if tackled at a right time.
Is there anything else you would like to share?
Nee, I think this is what basically is. That now that media is... So media can make or break any situation. And my message to all the educated people, all the youth today, is don't get carried away. Don't have that mob mentality. You are educated, you are intelligent, you have seen the world, you are exposed to so many things, what is happening around the world. Always judge, make your brain work, and then proceed. Don't follow. That's not worth it.